how small can transistors actually get? IBM seems determined to try to find out. Hi folks, welcome to a mini episode of Upscaled. I promise we've got more full-length episodes on the way, but we wanted to take a minute today to talk about the news that IBM has announced that they have the design process in place to build 2-nanometer transistors. For your super simplified refresher, generally smaller transistors means they either can run faster or use less power. The naming conventions between companies aren't always equivalent, but most high-end chips these days are being built at around a 7-nanometer process, with some like Apple's M1 and some of their iPhone chips already at a 5-nanometer design. Now, going from 7 to 2 maybe doesn't seem like as big of a jump as going from 45 nanometers to 22 nanometers, but keep in mind that is potentially 3.5 times smaller. With chips like these, IBM is claiming you could do something like maybe build a smartphone that runs for 4 days in between charges, or massively reduce server and data center energy usage, or maybe cram as many as 5 billion transistors into a space the size of a fingernail. Quick aside, fingernail is a metric that gets used way too often in these types of announcements. Just tell me, is that a square centimeter? Like, whose fingernail are we talking about here? Now, the reality is whenever chips do take a big leap forward in terms of performance, software makers tend to find a way to use up that performance, or they just skimp on optimization. So don't expect your 4-day smartphone to arrive anytime soon. But there is big potential here for improved chips for everything from phones and servers to, say, cars and factories. One of the most interesting parts of this announcement is not actually the size of the transistors, but that they're going to be built with a new so-called nanosheet design. Now, if you folks are interested in this stuff, maybe we can try to do a whole transistor design episode at some point, but here's the gist. Up until this point, almost all the transistors in high-end chips are built with a design called FinFET, which debuted a decade ago. FinFET takes the channel, which is essentially the part that current flows through when the transistor is turned on. Remember, a transistor is really just a tiny electrical switch, and it stretches that channel up into a vertical fin. This makes the gate, the bit that actually controls whether that channel is open or closed, wrap around the fin on 3 sides. And this improved contact helps make the transistor less leaky. It helps keep power from passing through when it shouldn't.
This breakthrough invention allows Intel to create transistors that are smaller, faster, and use less power than ever before, enabling a new generation of computing technology in every category.
This new design turns the channel from that fin into a stack of tiny ribbons, or nanosheets, with the gate material wrapped entirely around them. In fact, while people do seem to be calling this nanosheet design now, when I first heard about it, it was being referred to as gate all around. As transistors get tinier and tinier, this problem of keeping current from leaking through the gate has been one of the main challenges, and this nanosheet design is being claimed as a possible solution. These designs are more difficult to make, and they require many astronomically thin layers of material stacked and built into complex structures all at the nanometer scale, but they do actually offer some big potential advantages, including varying the width of the sheet in different parts of the chip to accommodate different electrical needs, or even a proposed Intel design that just stacks multiple layers of transistors on top of each other. IBM's manufacturing partner on these new chips is Samsung, and they've even announced they're exploring nanosheet design for their upcoming 3-nanometer transistors. Samsung has also been aggressively scaling up their EUV or extreme ultraviolet manufacturing capabilities, and you can bet these nanosheet designs will almost certainly require that technology to achieve these tiny, tiny sizes. Interestingly, TSMC, the chipmaker who currently holds the performance crown with their cutting-edge projects, has said they are actually sticking with FinFET design at least through their 3-nanometer node. So when should you expect your new 2-nanometer high-performance desktop chip? Well, not for a while. This is a big advancement, but for some context, IBM first announced 5-nanometer chips all the way back in 2017. It took 2 years for those to start showing up in phones at all, and we are just starting to see chips built on that technology in laptops. So it might be a little while. If we get lucky, maybe we will see the rumored Samsung, Google, custom Android processor design built on 2 or 3 nanometers in 2023. But until then, it is still pretty exciting to see the first major redesign in transistor technology since 2011. Let us know what you think in the comments below. Does an episode on transistor design sound interesting? For our next full show, we are currently planning to dig into what's new in camera sensors. So if there's anything you're curious about there, let us know and we will do our best to explain it. Until then, be sure to like and subscribe, and we'll catch you next time.